Welcome back. In the last video, we have studied different properties of nanoparticles, how the properties change at nanoscale, and what are electrical, optical, mechanical, thermodynamic, chemical, and magnetic properties of nanoparticles that we have discussed in the last two videos. In this video, we will discuss different applications of nanoparticles. Now, due to change in properties at nanoscale, these nanoparticles have application in every walk of life, like from biotechnology, pharmaceutical, medical, to mechanical, civil engineering, electronics engineering, computer, etc. So, different applications we will discuss now. Just one by one, we will just state all these applications. Now, the first application is electrochromic display. So, what is electrochroma? Chroma means color. So, change in color, or we can say change in optical properties when electric field or voltage is applied. Okay. So, the device which works on this principle is called as electrochromic device. So, in this electrochromic device, we use nanocrystalline material like tungstic oxide. So, it displays the information by changing the color when voltage is applied. So, we may apply this principle to smart windows. Okay. Now, next application of nanomaterial is self-cleaning glass. Now, we have studied the chemical properties of nanoparticles. They are highly reactive. Since these particles are highly reactive, so if we have certain surface, for example glass, and if it is coated with nanoparticles, okay, then it becomes photocatalytic and hydrophilic. Okay, so photocatalytic means what? We make some light energy, for example ultraviolet rays incident on that glass. So these nanoparticles, they are energized. And if any organic particles are there on the surface, or if any foreign particles are on the surface, so these nanoparticles, they react with these foreign particles and they break down these foreign particles into small particles. And these nanoparticles are hydrophilic in nature. Hydrophilic means it attracts water droplets. So it is hydrophilic, so it attracts water droplet, and with these water droplets, these foreign particles which are broken into small particles are cleaned out, or they are washed out, and thus it remains clean, or it is a self-cleaning effect. We don't need to clean that glass surface and again it remains as it is. So we can apply this principle to your wall in the home, so we need not have to wash it or clean it, or again we don't have to color it again and again after definite interval of time. Now, opposite to this effect, we have the lotus effect, so which also has the same effect of self-cleaning. Okay, now why do we call it as a lotus effect? If you see the lotus leaves, we know lotus, it grows in mud or water. But in spite of this situation or this environment, these lotus leaves are very clean. You might have observed it. It is because there is a very thin layer of nanocrystals on the surface of the water, lotus leaf. On the surface of the lotus leaf, there is very thin layer of nanocrystals. These are biological nanocrystals. Okay. Due to this, it becomes hydrophobic in nature. Due to these crystals, nanocrystal surface, when water is there, water drop is there on the surface, it forms the obtuse angle of contact. Okay. We know if it is hydrophilic, it has acute angle of contact, and if it is hydrophobic, means it repels the water, it forms obtuse angle of contact. So the water drop you might have seen on the lotus leaf, it rolls down the surface of the leaf because it is hydrophobic. Okay, so it rolls down the surface of the leaf, and when it rolls down, it carries the dust along with it. Okay, when water droplet is there on the surface of the leaf, it forms obtuse angle of contact and therefore it rolls down. Okay, and when it rolls down, it carries dust along with it and the surface of leaf, it remains clean. So this effect we call it as a lotus effect. And we use the same effect artificially. We coat any surface with such nanocrystals so that it becomes hydrophobic and we get the same effect. So this is called as lotus effect. Okay. So this is about the self-cleaning property. Now next property, next application is scratch resistant coating. Now we know the nanoparticles are very hard and strong. So if the glass is coated with these nanoparticles or nanocrystals, it becomes very hard and therefore it becomes scratch resistant. So we can apply it or we can use it to the car so that it becomes scratch resistant. Okay. Now next application is sunscreen. Now here we use the zinc oxide or titanium oxide in nanoparticles. They absorb the UV rays. These nanoparticles, they absorb the UV rays. And so if we use it in sunscreen, it gives protection against the UV rays. Now we use the same principle here in clothing also. So what we do here, fabric is coated with these nanoparticles of zinc oxide. So it absorbs the UV rays. So these clothes, they are coated with zinc oxide particles, nanoparticles. They give protection against ultraviolet rays. If there are silver nanoparticles in that fabric, it has antibacterial effect. Okay. So it protects it from bacterial infection. Next application is harder cutting tool. Now again we use the same property. These are very hard nanocrystalline material. It is very strong and very hard. So if we use it in cutting tool, okay, we use the material like tungsten carbide, titanium carbide, etc. So it becomes wear resistant and it also becomes the long lasting and it can be used to cut very hard material. Next application is ductile machinable ceramic. Now we know ceramics are hard and brittle in nature. But if we use the zirconia, nano-sized zirconia, it becomes superplastic. Now what is the superplasticity? It can be deformed to great extent. So that we call as a superplasticity. So this zirconia, it becomes superplastic and therefore it can be used in high strength spring, ball bearing, wall lifter, etc. Okay. Now next, it is used in sensor because there is drastic change in electrical, chemical, magnetic properties of a nanoparticle or at nanoscale. So we can use it to construct different sensors. Okay. Next, very important application is in environment. The first, it is better insulation material. We use here aerogels. Okay. Aerogel, it is a network. It is a network. And we know in the network, there are empty spaces. So this empty space, if it is filled with air or if it is filled with gas, it is called as an aerogel. So it is highly porous, extremely porous structure. And therefore, it is extremely lightweight with very, very low density. And since it is filled with a gaseous material, 95% of the aerogel contains air or gas. So obviously it is insulating in nature. And therefore it can be used for insulation in offices, homes. So what is the advantage of using aerogel for insulation? That it do not emit chlorofluorocarbon, CFC. Now we know generally whatever insulating material we use today, it emits CFC, okay, and it is hazardous to the environment. But if we use aerogel, it do not emit CFC. So it can also be used in smart window. Okay, pollution control. The same we have discussed in self-cleaning glass. It is highly reactive, so it reacts with pollutants like carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide, and it convert into other compound which is less hazardous or less harmful, and thus it reduces the pollution. It saves energy because if we use these materials, nanomaterials like carbon nanotube or thin film or quantum dot in devices. So those devices are called as a nano devices. Since they are extremely small in size and highly effective, they require less energy for their operation, and again they are highly effective. So it is used in energy conservation. Okay. Next application in molecular electronics, when we discussed STM, scanning tunneling microscope, we have seen that it can be used to drag and drop the molecule. So we use the same principle and we develop the molecular electronics. Certain organic molecules, the molecule themselves act as p-n junction, and the molecule can be used as a p-n junction in the circuit. So that gives rise to new branch that we call molecular electronics. So if we use these molecular diodes, it leads to miniaturization of integrated circuit. Okay, so it has low power, high package density and high speed, and whatever limit, now integrated circuit we use. Now in the integrated circuit, thousands of electronic components are incorporated into a very small chip of silicon, but it puts limit on the number of components. But if we use molecular diode, there is no limit on the number of components, electronic components that can be incorporated into integrated circuit. Next application is in computer memory. We use here atomic scale memory using the atoms of silicon. So here atom, it represents one. And the gap, so atom we know spherical. So you imagine that spheres are arranged one after the other. So between two spheres, there is a valley. You can imagine. So that gap, that is the valley, it represents zero and the atom represents one. Okay. And so we use in memory. Then medical application. So here we use nanobot, that is nanoscale robot that can be inserted into the body for imaging and diagnostic purpose. And then next is the targeted drug delivery. Okay, so what is the targeted drug delivery? Whatever drugs we use today, these are not actually given to only that organ or the infected area. Actually, it is distributed throughout the body. And therefore, a very small portion of the drug is received by the organ which requires it. But if we use targeted drug delivery, it is given only to that particular organ. So it helps to decrease the dose and hence decrease the side effects. So it can be used in cosmetic drug delivery, then self-cleaning coating, antimicrobial textile, etc. Okay, so these are the some applications of nanomaterials. We have seen different applications. The most important application is in medical, that we use the nanobot. Now we say it is for diagnostic purpose, but in near future, it may be used for surgery also. And the targeted drug delivery, it is also very important. So, okay, friends, these are applications. So, we stop here.